everyone. Ms. Moody here. Hope everyone's doing their part to flatten the curve. I know I've been staying in, doing lots of videos. My daughter and my sister are both nurses, so I do worry about them, but they are staying safe. And I am quarantining with my cat. Anyway, today I'm so excited about this book. It's True or False, Incredible Kids. Now, I have to say what's been nice is book companies that normally sell their products are opening up their platform for students. So after I'm done reading the book, I want to show you. You'll see my little face in the corner of the screen. I want to show you how you can get it. Give you the username and password, save it on your browser. And these world books are beautiful books. So I hope you take advantage of it. And you know, with like watching a video, you can stop, write the password down, start it up again. So anyway, it's a world book. I'm going to show you that, how to use that platform, these free, beautiful books. And there's other things included in too. And then today we're doing Incredible Kids. True or False, Incredible Kids, published by World Book, read by Miss Moody. True or false, you have to be at least 16 years old to be incredible. False. People of all ages can be incredible. What incredible things will you do? True or false? A teenager invented Braille, a system of reading used by people with blindness and other vision problems. True. At the age of 15, the Frenchman Louis Braille, 1809 to 1852, developed the writing system that bears his name. He had been blinded in an accident at age 3. Braille is written in raised dots and read by touch. True or false? In 1960, 6-year-old Ruby Bridges was arrested for protesting segregation, separation based on race. False. Ruby Bridges was one of the first black students to integrate an elementary school in the Deep South region of the United States. Before that time, blacks in the Deep South were not allowed in white schools. Ruby bravely walked past protesters to her class. True or false? Kids have invented such fun things as toy trucks, trampolines, and popsicles. True. Kids invented these fun things and many others. You might enjoy playing with toy trucks, but don't try to double your fun by jumping on a trampoline with a popsicle. True or false? Albert Einstein named the dwarf planet Pluto. False. In 1930, an 11-year-old girl in England suggested the name for the newly discovered object. Her name was Vanetta Burney. True or false? Eason La Chapelle was the first architect in history. His first masterpiece was a chapel, a building for religious worship. False. La Chapelle is an American engineer. As a teenager, he created a robot hand and eventually an entire robotic arm. True or false? The American athlete Simone Biles became the first gymnast in Olympic history to earn a perfect score. False. The Roman gymnast Nadia Comăneci was the first to get a perfect score. In 1976, at the age of 14, she scored a perfect 10.0 for her skills on the uneven bars. True or false? Anne Frank, a German Jewish girl, wrote a diary while hiding from the Nazis during World War II, 1939 to 1945. True. Frank started writing her diary when she was 13. The diary was published in 1947 and has been translated into more than 60 languages. True or false? You must be at least 21 to win a Nobel Prize, an award that honors someone who has made a significant contribution to the good of humanity. False. Malala Yousafzai won the Nobel Peace Prize when she was 17. Yousafzai survived an attempt on her life by attackers who did not think girls should be allowed to attend school. Now she campaigns for the education of young girls. You know what, students, I'm going to stop here. And anyone that knows Ms. Moody, this is truly, she is one of my heroes. So now I'm going to end right here because the book does go on. And I want to show you how you can access these world books. They are beautiful. Okay, so we are at the district homepage. Right here under resources, which makes sense where the library would live. School, library, media services. And here I have a link, you know, to all the read-alouds. This ebooks and audiobooks resources. So, so many companies now are opening up their ebooks, which normally they would charge. So, different companies, and I give like different, you know, little hints or, username and password. What we read today was World Book right here. Now I want you to write this down. The username is WB Support and the password is Distance Learn. What's going to happen? The first time you click onto this, it's going to ask you for that username and password. You're going to put that in, and when your browser asks you to save it, save it. So here, that's what I did, and it doesn't prompt me for a username and password. I'm already logged in, so it's excellent. There are so many things on this web page, so many things, but I am focusing on the books, naturally. So if I click on E, and we are going to get all the books, and they are really nice. You can look up here, animals, insects, biographies. I'm going to scroll here just so you can get the feel for it. Mostly nonfiction. She got some fiction in there. Okay, oh, dinosaurs. I never get tired of dinosaurs. So let's see here. We'll click on. Okay, you can see it pull up. Easy peasy. And there it is, your book. So nice. Oh, I just love this product. So in short, this is the World Book. You have its WB Support and Distant Learn, and there are, oh my gosh, there's so many books out there for you to look at. I hope you try it, and if you do, if you shoot me an email, I'd really appreciate it. Oh, here, you can see this is audio, so this is something that you would just listen to. Okay? I think a lot of kids would like books in here. Oh, here's the one I read. Oh, I did like that one. Okay, Woodbury, take care.
Interrelate, take it down, alligator. I got a Chevrolet movie theater.